sight, in the interest of creating a lasting peace, I, Tom, and I, Jerry, do hereby swear to a treaty to end all hostilities and hereby maintain peace at last.
The Duke and Duchess have asked me to relay their compliments on your exemplary performance of late. And we've had not a single instance of mischief from mice. Well done! You can keep up the good work by sweeping the main hallway.
Well, hello, Governor!
All right, Geezer! Long time no see! Oh, look at that! It's as if you was expecting us! Don't mind if I do!
Cheers, mate!
Love a duck. Our wives got bees in their bonnets all over account we forgot their birthdays.
We'd be lying if we said we wasn't on the lam and angry as wolves.
So we thought we'd pay a visit to the host with the most, our good old cousin Jerry.
Truer words was never spoken.
Crackers! Oh, fresh baked biscuits. Hang on, Tick. You talking about that dozy old house cat we met last time we was here? Ah, we're not worried about him. Here, cousin, we saved the last biggie for you.
You say so.
Tom wins round one! Weightlifting's next. Why wait? Impressive, yes?
No.
Cross this off Tom's bucket list. Butch, confident with a can-do attitude. Tom has this one in the bag. Pretty trashy, Butch. Butch is taking on some heavy lifting. Looks like he's having some trouble. Well, that's not going to help. And Butch crushes Tom in the weightlifting portion of the competition. Up next, hot pepper eating contest.
You know, all of this is unnecessary. Really, I...
Let's see how the competitors handle the heat.
Your turn.
This is heating up at a fiery pace.
Getting bored.
Things are really heating up now.
Oh,
on the count of three. One, two, three! Hey! What?
Tom, I'm still cleaning up the mess you made. I let you back in, didn't I? And I even baked more cookies. This one's a little misshapen. Here you go, Tom. You're welcome.
What is it, Mr. Tom? Yes, charming!
How to save someone from drowning.
Oh, I'm just on badges.
Next to you, he was the best troop leader.
Hey, Uncle Jerry, when can we go camping again?
And you're coming too, right, Mr. Tom?
Bad show, old boy. The worst possible. Now, what have you to say for yourself? What's this? Giving up? Oh, no, I won't have it. When times are at their worst, we do not give up. Not as a household or a nation. As long as there is life in us, we never say die. We never accept defeat. Now, I'll look after the drapes and the tapestries, and you look after this and the grounds. We'll do Her Majesty proud. Carry on, my good fellow. The hour is nigh.
Oh, I'm so excited.
The honor of a lifetime.
Wow, but don't faint right away.
Oh, look, here she comes. Lydia?
Oh, what a day this has been. I think I shall go straight to bed and dream of it forever.
A visit from the Queen.
The Queen.
The Queen.
Thank you.
Something?
Wow! Look at that incredible size! He could terrorize a whole town of mice! Possibly I shouldn't have said that.
I don't know, but we have to stop without him. Yikes! Good thing it's a small village. Me and my big mouthin.
Mokshnell! Mokshnell!
Thank you.
their cats and could fly.
He's gonna help Jellyfun Mouseling.
Yeah.
Yeah!
This should really cement his success in the circus.
What's this laying about? Now go get that mouse before he ruins our circus.
Nothing like being in a deep, dark, scary forest in the middle of the night, enjoying cheese balls with friends.
I'll eat to that.
Dig those gentle uke sounds, killer man.
Yep.
Wow. That music is really, really lame.
Yeah, it's so lame. It's cool.
Not bad, big dog. What do you say, Jake? Can he hang with us?
Sure.
Man, you're the coolest. Thanks.
Thank you.
What's up, dude?
I don't feel nothing.
Back again. Oh, my cat. Like I said before. Ooh, something's different. Did you hit the gym or something? They got me, little pals.
You and your big mouth.
So long, little pals. I believe you know how to handle this. Here, a widow mouse with muscles. Ain't that cute?
This has gone too far.
Tommy, look at you!
And your mighty mustache. fight over me.
Elevator boots.
The boys decided to inspect the sled and make sure no monkey business was underfoot. Do not open until July 4th? Well, you'll have to wait for July on that one. Puppies? Where are the full-size dogs?
The driver said puppies were lighter and could travel faster.
This is no time for puppy love, Tom. Gotta get these pups in harness and back on the trail. The detectives found themselves sledding north. Meanwhile, Droopy's rival was also setting up a makeshift camp. Boy, when this guy trains dogs, he really trains dogs.
Your dame.
I'm here at the camp, Mr. Spikington, getting ready to sabotage-itize them good guys again.
Just stop those dogs, boyo, and there'll be a nice tip coming your way.
You got it, boss man, man. Bet you never suspected little old me, did you? You did? Man, y'all watch too much dang TV. Roar, man. Roar! Must be a blown fuse. Howdy, y'all. Any of y'all interested in a slightly used bear suit?
Chair there, pal. How's about sharing and letting me take it for a spin? Some pal.
Ginger was just down the street. Hey! My chair! Wait till I get my hands on... Ooh, a donut! We'll be right back. my homeowner's insurance is gonna go through the roof again. Honey, you won't believe this, but...
Owner's fancy new throne, Tisk Tisk. What a shame. Sure we can help, on one condition.
You give us all a free joyriding, deal?
Thomas, have you lost your mind?
What? Are those my pearls?
I believe they are.
Oh, dear. Oh, this is most embarrassing.
Good show, Thomas, catching this thief of a beast. Though I do wish you'd have done it more neatly.
My sincerest apologies. It's quite all right. The valuables have been returned and no one seems to be hurt. Thank you for your understanding. We shall be going then. Come, I'll walk you out. I could almost swear I hear my aeroplane.
Thomas, what has gotten into you? As entertaining as this is, Thomas, Lady Lillian has places to go.
It really was lovely to see you, Lillian. Please do try to come visit again soon. Oh, that's kind of you. I promise to come back before the new year. Without Kevin, of course.
Thank you. can't wait to see what you've gotten me for this Valentine's Day.
I can't believe you don't have more faith in me.
Well, maybe it has something to do with last year's present, a plastic singing fish.
Those biscuits, do you hear? Or you'll be out in the cold too.
Well,
what on earth?
Well done, old boy. I'll go fetch the broom. The meaning of this. Thomas, I see they've made a proper man of you, and just in time. You're needed in the dining room immediately. Good work, Thomas, and welcome back. Boswell! Consorting with vermin? You've disgraced hunting hounds everywhere. Back to the kennel with you. Carry on, Thomas. We're most impressed.
Yeah.
running water. Stay out until you've dried off, mister. The world's only water-loving cat. Lucky me. What? I'm afraid to... You are so in for it now, mister!
Foolish mortal! You are now in my power! A cat's all that, but mine's are nicer. Giddy up!
My word, bit of a messy office, what? The name's Dane, Reginald Dane, world-famous secret agent Double K-9 with Her Majesty's Secret Intelligence.
How can you be secret and world-famous at the same time?
Don't get cheeky. I'm here on a special mission, and the Crown has designated you two as my partners here in the States. The crown jewels of the Queen's pet pooch are to be delivered here under secret cover. The three of us will see them safely to the town museum.
Package for Reginald Dane, world-famous secret agent.
See?
Ahem. Got a tip for me?
Yes, don't eat paint chips. This calls for my large cardboard box opening, but also quite deadly pocket laser. Its precision requires the utmost care when... So sorry.
Good thing you guys buy fedoras in bulk.
Low tech, how charmingly primitive. Ah, here it is.
A rubber chicken? Is that the royal dog toy?
Don't be silly. The royal jewels are inside. A clever plan to camouflage the priceless valuables.
Empty. Seems to have been some mistake. You should give the delivery company a call.
I know. Let's call in the delivery service. There seems to have been some sort of mistake. First, what say you tidy up around the place? It's a bit of a mess, don't you think?
So, after they cleaned up, they gave the delivery dispatcher a ring. The dispatcher admitted the rubber chicken delivery got fouled up because it was identical to another package sent to another building. He gave them the address and they all shook hands on it.
So I don't get a speaking role?
Sorry, but no. So the boys hightail it across town.
You Yanks take things rather literally, don't you? Ah, well, when in Rome.
To Lucaville, actually, but let's not split hairs, huh? They found the address and holed up in the building across the street where they conducted a stakeout to find the chicken. It turned out to be the Clown College, Prattfall Institute.
Hello. I believe I spy our chicken. We'll just grab the jewels, leave the chicken, and no one will be the wiser.
Thank you.
You can make snow angels on your own time, Thomas. Get inside and start building that fire.
Screaming lion drive by O'Brien.
That sound. That vial's about to blow. Yikes!
Well, it looks like the winning run is on deck. The cat and mouse are now pinch hitting for Wheeler. And it's an explosive home.